Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dr. Joyce Brothers, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn!
Terrific. Thank you for joining us. Would you join me in greeting all of the celebrated and gift? Hello there.
Hi, Gene.
Oh, they're all out there today,
where
huh?
Where are they from,
Gene? Medical
group. Oh, are these little old ladies from Upper Montclair, NJ? Yeah. Terrific. Welcome. Welcome to you, one and all. Are you all quite ready?
Oh, yes.
Quite ready. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Is the basic black all right without the pearls?
I think so.
Okay.
You know, of course, that a tie is a sex symbol and your sex life is in trouble.
Why? Really?
Very spotty.
Oh. I don't know. It works for me every time.
Don't discuss sex on
television.
There's
Jeff Geiba and Maggie Smith.
Let's say hello to those two people.
Hello, Jeff. What is that?
That's my pet frog.
That's your pet frog?
Yeah, he brings me good luck.
Is that really a frog? Oh, yes, it is a frog.
Is it dead?
Yes, it is dead. Jeff is the current champ. He's won $5,600. That's pretty good, right?
Terrific.
When he won the big ball of wax there, and last time we were together, his wife, who was in the audience, and how many months pregnant is she?
About seven.
Seven.
First, her and the doctor disagree, but...
Her and the doctor disagree, huh?
Mm.
All right, well, it'll all come out someday. And, yeah. And you'll find out who was right. And he's very happy about that because that's going to help pay for that delivery in 2 or 3 months, whenever it is. Maggie Smith is challenging him. She's lived here for a number of years. Her home is, her basic home is a place where there is a famous cathedral.
Right.
Where the Archbishop of Canterbury was done in, right?
Well, Jeff and Joseph.
Right. It's what's that?
No, I was speaking to myself.
Okay. And we finished round one, and the score is 1-0 in favor of Maggie, and round two will happen right after this. Good luck to both of you. Here we go. We'll push this button right here and reveal our second round question. This is the final round. Maggie, it's up to you. You may have A or B.
A.
A it is. For Maggie Smith, everyone plays except Nipsey.
Oh, no.
Right. You matched her in the first round question, so you don't participate. Ugly Edna told the photographer she wanted to pose nude for Penthouse.
Ah.
And he said, Ugly Edna, forget about Penthouse. Your picture belongs in a blank house. If you were blank, what would you write?
Yes.
Just write me a little answer. That's just for my own eyes. There.
I would say this, but I would pronounce it very funny.
Oh, that's interesting. Forget about Penthouse. Your picture belongs in a blank house.
Right.
All right.
I will destroy this because I'm a nice fellow.
That's right.
And I don't want Jeff to laugh too loud because his son may be born naked.
Okay. Everybody ready down here? We'll begin with Maggie Smith's response. When Ugly Edna told the photographer she wanted to pose nude for Penthouse, he said, Ugly Edna, forget about Penthouse. Excuse me, your picture belongs in a blank house.
Outhouse.
Outhouse is a good response.
What did she
said,
say?
Outhouse. You have those in Maine, don't you?
Oh, goodness gracious, yes, we have. No, we don't have any inside plumbing. All we have are outhouses.
Outhouses. There's one for Maggie Smith. Charles?
Being very connected with opera and the various languages in opera, I will answer in Italian. And if there are any Italians, this is the correct answer. A baccalza!
A baccalza. That's an outhouse.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A baccalza.
Definitely.
Bacalza. Bella figlia del Bacalza. Yes, hello there.
Hello there.
You remember me?
Indeed I do.
What would you like to do for me?
What I'd like to do is just hide under the table, because us dignified psychologists shouldn't say such a thing.
You shouldn't say out of house. Well, you could say Bacalza. That's four for Maggie. Maggie's doing okay, Richard.
Out, damn spot.
Out, out. That classes it up a little bit when you quote a Shakespearean line. It helps take the... What do you say?
Out.
Out. Out, out, out. Got them all. Jeff?
I get B again. Now.
What?
I get B again.
You get B?
Right.
Okay. B is what you get.
Good luck.
That was a good choice. B for baby.
B for boy.
When little Johnny the Cannibal brought home a friend, he said to his mother... He followed me home, Mom. Can I blank him?
Got it.
Got it.
Got it, got it, got it.
Everybody got it. Okay. She's about ready. We'll come over here and talk to Jeff Geiba, give him plenty of time to think it over. Jeff, when little Johnny the Cannibal brought home a friend, he said to his mother,
He followed me home, Mom. Can I blank him?
Can I eat him?
Eat him.
Yeah, eat him.
Eat him. Now, Jeff, I point out to you, you must match every celebrity to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Nipsey,
we come little to you. Johnny told him, said, I want to take you home for lunch. Can
eat.
I eat him?
Ah. All right. What do you say to that?
I'm hungry as a bear. I gotta eat him.
Eat him. Okay. Score is now 2-6. Charles?
Being associated with opera in the various...
Mangiare!
Mangiare! Six to three is the score.
Is he called me home, Mom? Can I eat him? What do you say?
In some cultures, primitive ones, food is dirty words. They use it. And the worst thing you could say is you eat with your mother-in-law. And so he's eating.
Oh! There's another one for him. 6-4. You match two more, Jeff, and you tie the score. Richard?
Eat, damn Spock.
Eat. He's talking to his dog, Spot. Yeah. Eat, Spot. What's wrong with you? Now, Patty.
Yes?
It's up to you.
Yes?
Either he ties or loses.
I said have him for dinner, which
have
is
have him for dinner, which is eat. Then we got a tie score. That's the way it goes. 6-6 there. Yeah, two good players here, and we'll see how this tie ends up in a moment or so. But right now, we got to find out about this. Pay attention. Hello there. Now, I should have done this first. Got mixed up there. Blow the fuse first. Bing, there it is. Tied. Now, one question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Maggie?
I'll take A again.
You want A? Okay, Maggie. You got A. Ready?
Yep.
Mrs. Count Dracula said...
All good in accent.
You're gonna get it, Patty Deutsch. She said...
What did she say?
She said...
Oh, she did.
No, she didn't say that. She said, not a soul in Transylvania knows this, but my husband, the Count, sleeps with a blank.
I thought you promised us an accent.
Not a soul in Transylvania knows this, but my husband, the Count, sleeps with a blank. It's very easy.
Not a soul in Transylvania knows this, but my husband, the Count, sleeps with a blank.
Not a soul in Transylvania knows this, but my husband, the Count, sleeps with a blank, blank, blank.
Blank, 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 blank,
blank, blank, blank, blank, blank, blank, blank. Okay.
Oh.
We're ready.
Oh.
Come on, let's go. I'll fool around.
Yes.
Oh, wait.
No fooling around on this show.
Okay.
Okay. We'll start without him, right, Maggie? Think it over carefully. Mrs. Count Dracula said,
Not a soul in Transylvania knows this, but my husband, the Count, sleeps with a blank.
With a bat.
Bat is good. Good. What do you say to that?
Well, I thought he needed something soft and warm, so I said a cuddly bat.
A cuddly bat. There's one for her.
And you?
You booed a right answer?
You know what happened? I remember Linus in Charlie Brown? He's carrying a little blanket with his little thumb in his mouth. It's a Linus blanket. That's not a bad answer.
That is absolutely a terrible answer for this question.
Oh.
We're going to try and write a question someday that'll fit that answer. This was not the question for that answer.
Oh, kiss me, you fool.
Later. Charles.
I think this is a match, and again I answered in Italian, Vampira.
Vampira. Vampire bat, that's right. Vampire bat. That's two for you, Maggie. Now, Joyce, my husband, the Count, sleeps with a...
Well, I'm glad Charles matched him, because I was beginning to bleed internally. I said vampire, too.
There you go, that's three for her.
Vampire bat. Because he goes around scaring everybody. You know?
Yes.
And really... He sleeps with a teddy bear.
Oh.
That was my answer.
Some of you like that, I take it.
You
like that?
Watch this
screen. Apparently, a lot of people around here sleep with teddy bears.
Doesn't make you a bad person.
No, it doesn't make you. What do you say, Patty?
I said a teddy bat.
Teddy bat. Bat. Right. Hey, that ain't bad, is it?
That's great.
Four for her? Now, let's see what we've got for you. You'd like B, right?
Right.
Oh, okay, thanks. That's B for baby, because his wife is about to have him. Hey, did you hear about the old folks bar?
No, what about the old folks bar?
Let me tell you about the old folks bar. They have blank on draft. Oh, caught you unawares there, didn't I?
Oh, shit. Why?
The old folks bar. They have blank on draft. At the old folks bar.
How do you say get the hook in Italian?
Faccia la finestra.
No, you know how you say get the hook in Italian?
Non me fa scombari.
Vamos.
Vamos. All right, everybody ready? Okay, Charles, here we go.
Wait a second.
Come on, Charles.
Come on, Charles. We're sick of it.
Can't wait around for you all day.
Wait a minute. Uno momento.
Here he goes. He's finished.
Okay.
Aspetto.
Aspetto. Hear about the old folks bar, Jeff?
Yeah, I heard about it.
Oh, yeah.
But I don't think it's the same one I know.
You don't want to hear about it then, no.
It's not the same one I know.
Really? They have blank on draft.
Something for the stomach, like Pepto-Bismol. So, you
know. Pepto-Bismol on draft.
It's all right. It's all right.
Jeff, I'm glad you won $5,600 at least.
You it's not the that? Same bar I go to.
Can't take that away from you?
No.
Even with a rotten answer like that, we wouldn't take a nickel away from you. Nipsey, what do you say? He says Pepto-Bismol.
At the old folks bar?
At the old folks bar.
Oh, no, they got prune juice.
Prune juice. There's one. Do you, Miss Brett, honey?
Now, Linus Blanket is like a teddy bear. You didn't like that last answer?
No, I hated that answer.
No, Anita did.
Get ready. I said Orifex.
Orifex.
Isn't that terrific? Listen to them cheer and stand up.
Orifex on draft.
Thank you for the standing ovation, but come back to your seats.
Orifex does not flow. On draft. Charles, did you get the idea?
I said blood plasma.
Blood plasma. So that means Maggie Smith wins the game. What the rest of you have? Okay. Congratulations. Hang around there on the tape, and we'll get back to you in a moment or two. Now, Jeff, you are not leaving empty-handed because we have $5,600. We're very happy for you.
I wanted to thank Diane.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye.
They say goodbye. Oh, listen, while I'm having a sip of water, you watch this commercial here. It's very edifying. Go away. Oh, Here we go. Maggie Smith is up here the first time. Now, she's only won $100, which is not bad, is it, Maggie?
No.
But you could win over $5,000 here now if you do well and concentrate and get your ESP going with our celebrities over there. We have these 100 little old ladies from Upper Montclair, NJ, and we'll tie them to the seats and lock the doors, and we ask them to get right down with their, they had pencils in their mouths, and we said, write your response to this thing, slide it, Earl, there. It was honey blank. And the answer they wrote down most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. Now, their second most popular answer is worth $250 to you, and the third, $100, and you may solicit some answers from our celebrities.
Richard?
Honey Bee.
Honey Bee.
Brett?
I have two. Honeysuckle.
Honeysuckle.
And Nipsey?
Honeydew.
Honeydew. I think they gave you three good ones. Mm-hmm. Honeybee, honeysuckle, honeydew, honeybee, honeysuckle, honeydew.
There's honeymoon there.
And honey, that's another possibility, but you may have one that you like better than any of those three, and it's your prerogative to choose that if you wish.
I thought of honeybee.
Honeybee is what you want. Okay, that's what we're looking for, right up there, and we hope it's up the top spot for you, because that'll get you the most money. We'll begin at the bottom, however, and we will reveal the $100 response. Honeydew. There's one answer that one of our celebrities gave you.
Honey.
We are looking for honeybee. Let's see if it's under the $250 number. Honey bun. Mary Martin's famous song from South Pacific. Okay, last chance for honeybee. Slide it, Earl.
No.
Yes, you got it. Congratulations.
Very good. Very good. So, Maggie, you're all up to $600 now. And you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Remember what you have to do to collect it.
Richard.
Going to try and match Richard. That's what she's going to try and do. Stand on the tape there. And here is the question worth $5,000. Get your ESP flowing to him. Is it flowing?
Oh, yes.
Good. Her ESP is flowing to you, Richard.
I know.
Blank girls. Or blank girls. I'll accent it both ways for you. Blank girls. Blank girls. Okay. Blank girls. Now you have to give us an answer which will match his. And if it does, you collect the $5,000.
All I can think of is showgirls.
Showgirls. Okay. Richard, she says showgirls will match you for $5,000.
You were close. I said playgirls.
Playgirls. Some
girls is better. I didn't know that.
Showgirls. Some showgirls are playgirls, but not all of them. And that means you've got the $600 and a chance to have a go at another game here. So shall we welcome another player? Here is Jim Grove coming on right now. Jim Grove. Hello, Jim. All right, you can get back on the carousel while we ask Jim Grove where he's from and all that sort of thing.
I'm from Agoura, California.
Yeah.
Fireman for the city of Beverly Hills.
You're a fireman?
Yes.
Say again where your home is.
Agoura, California.
Agoura.
Near Thousand Oaks.
You live in Thousand Oaks?
Plus by Thousand Oaks. Agoura's by Thousand Oaks.
Oh, it's by a Thousand Oaks.
Yeah.
Whatever that. I haven't understood a word you've said all evening. Say A or B.
B.
B. He did that very well, didn't he? Yes.
Yeah.
Dr. Simmons, the surgeon, used to be a farmer.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And that's why when he takes out your appendix, he does it with a blank.
Got it.
Dr. Simmons, the surgeon, used to be a farmer. And that's why when he takes out your appendix, he does it with a blank. Good. All right. Very good.
Isn't that a terrific little answer, sir?
Terrific little answer, Brett.
That's making up for the earlier horror.
Well, we're back to the doctor here.
Right. Okay. Here we go, Charles. Going to start without you. Oh, you're ready. Okay, Jim. Dr. Simmons, the surgeon, used to be a farmer, and that's why when he takes out your appendix, he does it with a blank.
Pitchfork.
Pitchfork is very good. All right, Nipsey, show and tell.
Anytime you're going to throw away something on the farm, you use a
pitchfork. There's one for Jim. Brett.
You may not be able to understand him, But he comes up with the right answers.
Yes, he do.
Charles?
Pitchfork.
Pitchfork. Three for Jim. Joyce?
My farmer's going to do a big job, plow.
A plow.
Cloud up the appendix, Richard.
Son of plow.
Oh, and you got enough. Three plows and three pitchforks, and that's the way it goes. Now you stand by while America watches this message.
Well, Jim, you see where you're from?
Two on three. Coming out on three. Okay, no two. Three.
Coming out of the shoot on
two.
Three.
Two, three. Two, three. Just have a few seconds. Say goodbye. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Not forever. Adieu. Temporary.
Never goodbye, just so long.
So long. Until we meet again. And we will meet again.
Long.
Because we're a magnetic. Can we have the violin section a little stronger, please? Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Sarah Kennedy, Richard Dawson, thank you, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you.
Hello there. Oh, I had to put
nice
my
to
glasses
see you, my
on.
I haven't seen you in a while.
Oh,
and you,
bad.
Sir, we saw
very nice.
And I saw this character recently, but we did show-offs together and had a marvelous time.
Really?
And I want to thank you for being a gracious host.
Thank you, and I want to tell you, we're going to have you and Dickie back immediately because we had such a good time. It was a fabulous show.
Well, thanks a lot,
Bob. Oh, no.
You and Alan were terrific, too, Ben.
I tell
you
what
you're
going to get.
You're going to go back there.
I don't know what I'm going to get.
No, without Alan. No, you're not going to get anything. What kind of talk is that? All right. Is there something I can do for
no,
you?
No, we just having
I loved you.
Talk.
You're having a talk?
Your vision
yeah.
And blue. I
yeah,
love your
very nice
outfit.
With the turtleneck.
I look
and
nice
I
with the
like
turtleneck.
Your belt.
That's how, I have
Smart.
A long swan-like neck. That's why turtlenecks
cavalier.
Look beautiful on me. Shall
you
I model
are
it
cavalier.
For you? Now let's say hello to our two players, Deanne Zabrock and Mary Lattimore.
Yes.
This little lady won $5,600. What are you going to do with all that loot, Deonza?
Well, I said I was going to quit work, and then I had to go to work today.
You
this
did?
Morning.
What did he say?
Well, he's supposed to be here. I don't know if
did
he's
you,
here.
Did you change your mind about quitting work?
Well, I'm going to stay a week.
How did your boss greet that news that you were quitting?
Well, I think he was happy for me.
He was?
Yes.
I mean, you didn't go in and spit in his eye or anything. Say, I quit.
No.
I'm rich. I don't need your job. I got a lot of money. You didn't do that, did you?
We had a party this morning. In the
oh.
Office.
Oh, well, terrific. Okay. Now, Mary, it's nice to have you with us. Did we? Shall we find out a little more about you, Mary Lattimore?
Be nice. I'm Mary Lattimore, and I work for the Los Angeles City School System. I am an assistant principal, and I'm married to a sergeant in homicide, and I have three beautiful children.
Well, you should have, because you're a beautiful lady.
Thank
isn't she
you.
A pretty
yes.
lady?
Yes.
She must have. Beautiful baby. All right, we'll start this game in a moment or so, but right now we've got this message for you. Here we go. I'll push this button right over here and ask our challenger, Mary Lattimore, to make a selection.
Please.
It is. New game. Everybody plays.
Right.
Eddie asked Dumb Dora to play post office. Mm-hmm. So Dumb Dora blanked his foot.
Are you astounded?
I am astounded.
You are astounded. Eddie asked Dumb Dora to play post office, so Dumb Dora blanked his foot.
I'm finished.
Good, because you're a perfect person. He's a perfect person.
He's a little less perfect than I am.
Charles is a little less perfect than you are.
And I'm just finished.
More wrinkled.
And a little. No personal. You remember what Mother said? Do not make personal comments.
Oh.
Remember that? Didn't they teach that to you in finishing school in Maine?
Yes.
But what else they teach you?
I can't tell you.
All right. Everybody is now ready. We'll call him Mary Lattimore. What?
Sorry. I got to put it in there.
Okay. They're so busy with their own shows, they forget.
Now that you're a host of your own
show, they don't know where they are.
I don't have to put anything in the slot of my show.
Yes. Oh, all right.
In the booth, that's all.
Okay. Now, Mary Lattimore.
Honestly.
Eddie asked Dumb Dora to play post office, so Dumb Dora blanked his foot.
Kissed his foot.
That's how you play post office. Now, wait a minute. That's not bad. When you play post office, you kissed him. Weren't you ever a teenager? No? You were 18 years old when you were born, huh? All right. She said kissed his foot.
The first thing I thought of was what she said, and I said to myself, nobody would say that. So I said stamped his foot.
Stamped his foot.
Dumb. He was dumb. Dumb.
No? Those are the two good possibilities. Kissed his foot is good, stamped his foot is good. What do you say?
I thought as a kiss, too, and then I quickly wrote stamped because I was so thrilled with myself.
Charles, what about you?
And I was the first one finished.
Yeah.
After you copied, we all copied from Bobby.
I see. Stamped. Well, I'm sorry, Mary. So far, it's all stamped. Dumb Dora, Eddie asked Dumb Dora to play post office, so Dumb Dora blanked his foot and she said kissed.
Well, I said Dumb Dora was so dumb that she just stamped his foot.
Yeah. I don't think Dumb Dora really had it together this day.
That's why she's so dumb.
Kissing her foot, his foot would be a lot more fun than stamping on it, wouldn't it? What do you say to
that,
Richard?
Sick.
No, there's nothing sick about that. Let me show you.
No.
Come on, take your shoe off.
No.
Go ahead. No. I'll kiss your foot. No. I don't care what's his name. Is he watching today? What do you say here? You.
I say I'll kiss her other foot.
Okay.
I hate to see that. Look, you have such a darling smile. Mm-hmm. I figured you were going to get six like that.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure that we all have it stamped.
Ooh, so five. Now, you have a foot
six.
Fetish.
Kiss my foot, yeah. Stamped.
Stamped.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry.
Okay, well, it could have gone either way, Mary. That's the way it is here. Deonza, this is your first round question. Gunga Dingy said.
Gunga Dingy.
Gunga Dingy said.
Read it first.
He said,
"Talk like that, by the way."
He says, "When I meditate, I really lose contact with the outside world." Last week, I was meditating. While I was meditating, I didn't even notice my blank was on fire.
Sweet.
When I meditate, I really lose contact with the outside world. Last week, while I was meditating, I didn't even notice my blank was on fire.
Got it, sweetheart.
While I was meditating, I didn't notice my blank was on fire. 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 Was someone kick the record player?
Can't Shot Tone play him? Who
played no!
Him?
What's your name? What's his
do
name?
Do not break your concentration because Franchot Tone has nothing to do with this question.
Franchot Tone was in that other one.
Bengal Lancers.
Yes, The Lives of the Bengal Lancers. The bamboo tells me he's
what is that?
Yeah.
Betty, I know when you're fiddling around with my ankle down there, something goofy is going on. Has Alan been out of town? Is that your problem?
I think I've been overseas too long.
Where are we here? Oh, this is yours. Gunga Dingy said, when I meditate, I really lose contact with the outside world. Last week while I was meditating, I didn't even notice my blank was on fire.
My beard?
My beard. Gungadini, did he have a beard?
I don't know.
Did not have a beard.
Did not have a beard.
Was clean-shaven man.
I mean, clean-shaven man, that's right. He did not have a beard. What do you say?
No bearding.
Well, I thought you'd get this. I wrote the simplest thing I could think of.
What's that?
His pants were on fire.
His pants were on fire.
I figured you'd say that.
Gungadini did not wake him. He wore a dress. You know Gungadini, he wore... Well, you do...
Wore a hoop skirt.
We don't call them dresses, but we call them something else. What do we call them over there?
They're called
Gingis.
Gingis.
We call them Gingis. Gingis. My Gingis on fire.
My Gingis.
Did he wear a little hat?
Gungadini?
A little cloche?
Yes. Yeah, sure, I think.
Little cloche, yes.
Yes. His little turban was on fire.
His turban, yeah. Sorry, that's not bad.
That's better than
Charles.
I don't know, but Gungadini will never be the same. No one knows if he had a beard, wore a dress, or what.
Sounds like a...
Toga, dress, or caftan, or robe, or whatever the...
That's it. That's the idea, too. Okay, now we're up to you, Sarah, my dear.
Yes, we are.
Well, you don't want to show it. You're ashamed about it, right?
No, I'm not ashamed. Well, maybe I should be. No, I thought if he lived in a house or a hut, you know, he was just sitting there and his little house started burning.
As we were meditating, I didn't notice my house was on fire.
It's a bad answer.
You are not only underweight, you are weird. What do you say, Richard?
I say, why don't we go somewhere quiet and kiss?
Do right, yeah.
Did I hear the question again?
Gungadini said, when I meditated, I really lose contact with the outside world. Last week while I was meditating, I didn't even notice my blank was on fire.
The little trousers they wear.
The trousers?
Little things.
Oh, yeah.
I said loincloth, but the real name, Gingi.
Gingi.
That's what they're called.
They call it Gingi.
Right.
Gingi. Yes.
I thought the Gingi was the river that they all jumped in after they were dead.
It's the Genji.
The Ganji.
The Genji. This is
no, that's after their Ganji. They were. No, I got wound up in my answer and said turban.
Well, turban. Oh,
you got wound up
I'm
in your sorry. Answer.
Yes, sirree. Another pitcher's duel going here, friends. Zip to zip is a score. Pay close attention. More of this excitement will continue right after this message. Lady wanted my socks as a souvenir, so I gave them to her.
Continuing with our Cinderella hunt.
Come here.
You think you can wear this?
Yes.
If it fits you, you'll go to the ball.
Terrific.
Woo!
Or would you like to see something in green?
No! Okay. Shall we carry on? We have been carrying on, haven't we? I'll push this button, we go to round two. Mary Lattimore, make a selection.
A, please.
A it is. Everybody plays again.
I just drink. I must tell you, if I'm sat at home now, I would be very cross.
Why?
Well, because they don't know. A lady from Coronado, very prettily, asked Jean for his socks. She'll pull
where,
them
oh,
up.
Oh, she's got them. Souvenir.
Well, otherwise, the people at home have no idea.
Oh, I thought I explained that.
No,
I
you
forgot
didn't.
About that. Thank you. Thank
Tune
you
Tune in
that.
Again tomorrow when his shorts will be
off. Not on camera.
Well, yeah, all right.
Here we go.
She does okay. Windows.
King Kong was hungry.
So, how hungry was he?
I'll tell you. He took two huge slices of bread. He went to the naval base. And he made himself a blank sandwich. King Kong was hungry. Took two huge slices of bread. Went to the naval base. And he made himself a blank sandwich.
I'm finished.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Got it? Got it? Got it? Got it? Ready? All right, lay it in there. Waiting for old Bob. Put it in the slot now, and away we go. Now we come to Mary Lattimore.
I don't know what that means.
You know what a naval base is, don't you?
Yes.
Okay, King Kong was hungry, so he took two huge slices of bread, He went to the naval base, and he made himself a blank sandwich. Now think about it.
Torpedo?
That's not bad.
It's not,
not
over
bad,
here.
But I don't think it's going to happen. Now, Mary, in a moment you'll see why, and I think it will be clear to you. Bobby?
Yes? Oh.
That's how you see Bobby's answer.
Torpedo is good, but there are some that might even be better. What do you say?
I don't know. I didn't know what to say, so I thought he went over there and made himself a Fay Wray sandwich.
A Fay Wray sandwich. Mary, that's worse than yours. No, that's worse than hers.
I know. No, I like hers.
Yes, her. What
you
do you say?
Now, the operative word was navel, was it
right,
not?
Right, right.
Not meaning belly button.
No, navel, where the boats hang on.
Well, meaning sailor.
I see we don't have any sandwich eaters on this panel.
Well, I hope yours is better.
Hello, Captain.
But he liked people, King Kong.
Yeah, that's true, but wait till you get... Now, wait a minute, it may come up here. Charles?
In keeping Gene and other panelists with the sea motif, which I'm so, recognized as...
Yes.
I said, Gene,
Battleship.
You fool.
What is it?
Well, what's the magic word? No socks and turtlenecks? What is it?
It's coming up now.
Sarah, it's coming up now. Does Sarah have the good answer?
Of course.
I don't know. Sarah will show you the perfect answer.
I
go.
Do. Okay, it's a submarine.
Mary, may I ask, have you ever heard of a submarine? Yes, you have. Okay, well, I guess it just slipped your mind.
I must tell you that I thought it was going to be like stamped. I thought it was going to be six submarines.
Is that how you do it? Everybody's
three
a submarine.
People.
Yes.
Enroll in your school immediately. Submarines.
Are you a sandwich eater?
No ship.
We have four people.
Some of us come from wealthy families.
We'll have your second round question in a moment, but right now we have this for you. Whee! Now, Deonza here is in a very good spot to win her second game. She's got $5,600. All she has to do is match one celebrity to win a second game.
All right.
Little Johnny was thrown out of the zoo when they caught him blanking in the kangaroo's pouch. Little Johnny was thrown out of the zoo when they caught him blanking in the kangaroo's pouch.
If I don't get it this time, I'm getting it. Well, you haven't...
Spelling doesn't count. Don't worry about it. We'll figure it out somehow. Okay, put it in that slot, Sarah. Yes. Splendid. Okay. All right, everybody's ready. And we come to... Deonza. You're not ready, Deonza? Have you been thinking about it all this time? You still have... Well, I'll read it one more time, give you a little more time to think. Little Johnny was thrown out of the zoo when they caught him blanking in the kangaroo's pouch.
This is awful.
What?
Wedding.
Wedding?
That's all that came to my mind.
Okay. One wet pouch wins the game.
What? One what?
One wet pouch wins
Except
the game.
Wee weeing.
Wee weeing wins the game. Sleeping, okay. She's very excited. I'm sorry to see you go, Mary Lattimore. You really are a beautiful lady. I know you've got beautiful kids. We've got a couple of gifts for you, and thanks for being with us on Match Game 75. Goodbye, Mary Lattimore. Now, step down here, and we'll have another go at it. You know how this goes.
I know.
You've been here before, so should we just start?
Let's go.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, Deonza, and we got their best response to this. Knuckle blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match the bottom one, you get $100. Three of the ding-a-lings are permitted to assist. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Richard?
A dance that fighters attend. A knuckle ball.
The knuckle ball. All right. Leave him alone. He's a star. And he's right 98% of the time, too.
Charles?
Did we get Knuckleball from that same brilliant mind that got Submarine?
Isn't that a ball that they throw? A
Knuckleball is
yes,
a very
yes, we'll explain it. There's a paper given out to the audience so that you're interested.
Well, we'll see if it comes up, Charles.
Pitchers use the Knuckleball.
Chuck says Knucklehead.
Knucklehead, okay.
Betty,
have you got one?
The more you look at knuckle, the funnier it looks. It's one of those words that gets sillier the longer you look at it.
Yes.
Knuckle under.
Knuckle is a funny word.
Knuckle under.
Knuckle under. Knuckle under, knuckle
I
ball, and knuckle head.
Knuckle
Why,
down.
You think all three are good, don't you?
Knuckle down.
No, dear, that's buckle.
Have you got a better one? Have you knuckle anything occur to you?
Mm-hmm, but knuckle I'll go with knuckle down. Ball.
Knuckle ball. Okay. That's the one that Richard gave you. All right, knuckleball.
$5,700 between us. Don't boo us, folks.
That's
please.
Right. You know, the fact is, baseball is a great American
Wouldn't
pastime. And knuckleball, I mean, anybody who watches baseball ought to know about that. So we'll find out if it's up there. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Knuckle down.
Knuckle You're not down. Even right. It's buckled down.
It isn't. It's
buckled down wins.
No, it isn't.
Knuckle down is the next chorus.
Knuckleball is what we want. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Knucklehead. All right. Here's the last chance. Charles gave you that one. All right. Here's the last chance for knuckleball. May we see the $500 response?
Correct again.
Said sandwich.
Did you almost say knuckle sandwich?
Oh, I can't.
Submarine expert.
Red had it.
I tell you.
Red had it.
You know, if you had said knuckle sandwich, it's not very likely that she would have. Would you have said knuckle sandwich?
That's what I thought of. I know that sounds awful.
Oh, listen, that didn't even do the thing. Did you? Did it occur to you? What is a knuckle sandwich? Is that when someone belts you in the mouth? Is that what a knuckle sandwich is?
How would you like a knuckle sandwich?
I got two knuckle sandwiches and a BLT.
And one submarine to go.
Well, Diaza, you've picked up another $100 here, and you're going to play another game. Are you ready to meet another contender?
Ready.
Here we come with Terry Thompson. Hello, Diaza. Okay, let's find out a little bit about Terry Thompson.
Okay, I've been in California for 11 years.
Yeah.
I'm a professor at one of the Los Angeles junior colleges, teach marketing, and I love to snow ski.
You do?
Yeah.
Downhill.
I try it downhill. It works a
well,
lot
I do
better
cross
that way.
Country.
Well, I'm not too good at that. It sort of wears me out, you know?
It's a very difficult score. But you see, when you're as young as I am and as strong as I am, you can do cross country. You older fellas, you can't do it.
That's right. I never thought of that.
Okay, now that we've alienated him, let's have a little commercial.
17.
Gee, I'm sorry, we got to stop right now. But you'll all be fresh as a daisy the next time we get together, and we'll start right from the top with a brand new game. I want to say you are absolutely splendid today, but you're going to be even better next time.
You mad?
Forget to watch Tattletales.
Oh, yeah, watch Tattletales with Helen What's-Her-Name. She's terrific. Gene Rayburn here, Match Game 75. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Joyce Boulevard, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Wilson and friends for joining us. Well, well, we got a new kid on the block, haven't we?
Oh, watch it.
Well, you know, we have a little tradition here. We have to give you a proper welcome.
What are you going to do?
Nothing. Nothing too fancy.
You are going to kiss me, aren't you?
Now, you can't be laughing when I do this.
Because we bump teeth.
That's right, we bump teeth.
You got to pucker up now.
Aww.
Oh, I like
welcome,
it.
Minnie Pearl. What the heck was going on over here? I didn't see your face. I was standing backstage. I saw the mom. Who was that?
That was Joyce Bullifant trying to get my job, but I've killed her.
She's on next week. She got all mixed up here. All right. Well, welcome back, Dickie boy.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see you again. Everything okay?
Everything's just great.
Grand.
What? Don't say hello to Charles and me. We don't
no,
give
for
a
4 years. For 4 years, no one has said hello to us. And it doesn't show so much on me, but look at her. Too late now. 4 years, we don't even get a hello.
Well, that's better.
You didn't even get the mouth spray.
We don't have a brother, we don't have a $1.98 hat, we don't have an accent, we don't have a cheese dog.
Joyce, it's next week.
Oh my God,
let me have my microphone table. Next week, Joyce. How many times do I have to tell you? Now let's walk.
I don't have anything to do today.
Well, go to my dressing room and wait for me there. Let's say hello to Barbara Hawkins and Diana Wells. Our current champion is Barbara Hawkins, who's won $1,800. Does that make you happy, Barbara?
Delirious.
Good. And she's going to be challenged by Diana Wells, who's had her first round question, right?
Yes.
The first ones are difficult, aren't they?
Well, I sure hope I do better next time.
Well, we'll see how you do. Now, we'll begin with her question, and then we'll get back to you. But first, we've got to get this to you. We are ready now. Here we go. The other round one question. Barbara, this is yours. Everyone will play. Here we go. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant, Harry said, "They serve the world's largest bowl of soup here. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it." When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it.
Arabia.
There's a blank in it. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant.
I used to eat a Saudi.
You did? Really?
Very good food.
Good food.
Sort of oily.
Never had that. Olive oil. I use a lot of olive oil.
Oil. Real oil.
Oh, real oil.
Yeah. Never mind. You just flew in.
Oh, I forgot. No, the jet lag's all gone already. Okay. Are you haven't got it together?
No, I have a hole in my pocket, and I keep losing.
You keep losing things.
I keep losing my parking meter money.
I have someone who can sew that up for you. Yes.
Who is that person who can sew that up?
Well, someone here, like Dayton Anderson. Anytime you're ready, Charles. We're just killing time here while you're thinking.
I'm finished. I've been finished for an hour and a half. Look at him.
You want to say something to Brett? Okay, what do you want to say?
My husband and I were out to Encino this morning, but we couldn't find a motel.
Brett will help you.
Don't tell her the name.
No. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant, Harry said they serve the world's largest bowl of soup here. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it.
A camel.
A camel. That's okay. I'll read it one more time. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant. What do you say to that?
I say that there's a whole camel.
A camel. There you go, Barbara.
Well, I thought they were famous for something. I said there was an oil well in it.
An oil well? All right. Now, Charles probably will come up with the definitive answer.
Sure. See,
when they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it.
Get this.
Oil well.
Oil well. Charles failed me. All right. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it, Minnie. What
it's a wig.
A wig! You got the idea! Five years, you got the idea right off the bat. Very good.
Very good. You got the idea. You're going to be okay.
Oh, you're cute. Me for you, kid, when the lights go out.
Okay. Now, what do you say to this, Richard?
Well, read it.
One more time.
Hey, I did a little play on words.
At the Saudi Arabian restaurant, Harry said they serve the world's largest bowl of soup here. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hare in it. There's a...
harem.
Harem! A lot of goodies on this one, aren't there? Yeah, so
yes.
You coming up with another goodie?
Well, I was thinking it was a rather large bowl of soup, and I live in Santa Barbara, and I thought of oil slick.
Oil slick. You've endeared yourself to your neighbors.
Absolutely. I suspect I'll be moving back.
Okay, so there we are at the end of round one, and the score is 1-0 in favor of the current champion, and now we go to round two. This is the final round, Diana. This is where you said you're going to do better.
And I'm going to try that A again.
You're going to try A again?
Yes.
All right, here it is. Rodney is so rich. He's so rich, after he drinks a case of beer, he pays a man to blank. All right. Well, that didn't take you long, did it? Got one? Okay. Now, Diana, Rodney is so rich, after he drinks a case of beer, he pays a man to blank.
How about tinkle for him?
Okay. What do you say to this, Dickie boy?
Well, I think before he does that, he would have the guy burp him.
Burp him, right. Those are the two good answers, tinkle and burp. And what do you say?
Pardon me. Burp.
Or belch.
Burp or belch, yep. Chuck?
Always the image of young mother. Burp.
Burp it is. So, Diana, you got three of those so far. You thought of that one, too? Was that your first idea?
Well, my husband does the other one more.
Oh. I see. What do you say to this, Minnie Pearl?
Burp.
You got four of those so far. And you? Burp. Five burps. And hello, darling.
You know, I love Minnie Pearl.
Yes, you do.
Oh. I wore this. It says
in your honor?
In her honor.
In her honor.
Now, you know, you may ask where I got this answer. There was an old dance team called Tinkle and Burp.
Tinkle and burp. So at this moment, the score is tied. Barbara will have a chance to untie the score and win the game right after we do this for you. Here we go. You know what you have to do, Barbara?
Yes, I do.
What?
Two.
No, one.
Two?
Because you got one. You see, score's tied right now. One to win is all she has to do. Dick, you lay out this time because you matched her in the first round. Hey, did you hear about the New York City traffic cop?
No.
Want to hear about him?
Yeah.
Sure.
When he lost his whistle, he stood in the middle of Broadway blowing his blank. New York City traffic cop. When he lost his whistle, he stood in the middle of Broadway blowing his blank. All right, here we go. Barbara, this New York City traffic cop, when he lost his whistle, he stood in the middle of Broadway blowing his...
nose.
Nose? One nose will win the game.
One nose, one nose.
There it is, that wins the game. What the rest of you have? Diana Wells, we admire you for the kind of work you do with young people.
Thank you.
We've got many gifts for you that'll be coming your way, and thank you for being with us in Match Game.
Thank you. I had fun.
Good. Goodbye. Now, Barbara Hawkins is up here for the third time. Third time. How do you feel?
I don't know yet. I have to go to the bathroom.
What? Can I say that? Sure. No, no, you can't say you have to go to the bathroom. No, that's not allowed there. I tell you, just let's not think about it or talk about it because it's 8 minutes before the next commercial, and we don't. So here we go, Barbara. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Joan Blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave us most frequently, you get $500. If you match the second most popular answer, you get $250, and then you get $100 for matching the third. And let's see who will give you some help here.
Richard.
Joan of Arc.
Joan of Arc is one.
Charles.
Charles.
Joan Baez.
Joan Baez. You got two now. And Brett.
What about Joan Rivers? What's that? How about Joan Crawford?
How about Joan Crawford? Mind like a steel...
sieve.
So it's Joan Crawford, Joan Baez, and Joan of Arc. Barbara, you may choose one of those or reject all of them and give us one of your own. What is your pleasure here?
Joan Crawford.
Joan Crawford. All right, that's the one that Brett gave you via Fanny. Here we go. What? My mic is breaking up. All right, I'll be very careful.
So is his mind.
There it is. I'll just hold it here very carefully, and we'll replace it during the next commercial. I will hardly move it at all. I was wondering where that noise was coming from. Thank you for pointing that out to me. Now let's begin at the bottom, and we will reveal the $100 response. Joan Rivers is up there. Do not move because the mic will make a funny noise. All right, here we go. May we see the $250 response? Joan Crawford, congratulations, you got it. Very good. So that means, well, before we get to that, what do you think's on a big one there? Joan of Arc. Ark, ark, ark. I thought there were a bunch of seals in the audience. Ark. Show us your ark, ark, ark. Go ahead. Joan of Arc is right. Okay. Bobby, you picked up an additional $250. You now have $2,150. You're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. That'll just about double your money there.
Oh, yeah.
And we'll be glad to give you that amount if you will match one celebrity exactly. Whom do you call on?
Do I have to turn like you?
No.
Richard.
Okay, Richard. All right, you face me if you would, please. Here we go. Sorry. Here it is, it's worth, whoops. I may get electrocuted before the show's over. You'll be a witness. We'll all sue CBS together. Here it is. Good luck to you. Blank Turn. T-U-R-N. Blank Turn. Blank Turn. Now, Barbara, give us the answer that Richard has written on the card. We give you $2,500. What do you say to this? Blank Turn.
Right.
Right Turn. That was your first thought.
No, it wasn't your first. Yeah.
It was not your first thought?
Well, my now, first was U-Turn. Well,
your first thought was U-Turn,
oh,
and you rejected
yeah,
that for Right Turn. Okay, let's turn to the left and find out what Richard has written on the card.
That's what I was hoping she was going to do.
What?
Turn to the left.
Turn to the left. You know, that was really an arbitrary one. I mean, kind of a difficult
left
one.
Left turn, right turn, no right turn, no left turn.
U-turn, right in the middle.
Good yes. turn.
Good turn is another
bad
good
turn.
One. A lot of good ones there. All right, Barbara, you're up to $2,150. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Mickey Eisley. Barbara, would you stand by for a minute?
I was supposed to do the show today, and I want to do it today, and there she is.
You get out of the set.
Well, I don't know how we can resolve this. Would you like to alternate with her, perhaps? On
I don't
other...
know. I think I'll get more money on this side than on that side.
No, you won't. I'm not giving you any money now.
I got to go upstairs and do a show.
What show are you doing?
Three's Company.
Oh.
Oh,
we'll come up and watch a little bit later.
Okay.
And we're going to see you next week. Joyce Philippot, ladies and gentlemen. All right. You have a seat, Barbara, and you want to do the commercial now. You don't want to recognize his presence at all. All right, you think about it for a second, Mickey. We'll do a little bit of business with America, and then you'll tell us the story of your life, okay? Here we go. Now, what do you say we all briskly applaud our new player here, Mickey Eisley. Yay, Mickey. How are you? Mickey, we'd like to find out a little bit about you before we start the game. What would you like to tell us?
Well, I'm 70 years old, a retired supervisor from the world's largest steel mill at Gary, Indiana.
No kidding.
And I married the prettiest girl in high school way back 52 years ago, still married to her. We have three sons, two of whom live in California. The other son and I came out for our granddaughter's wedding. How about that?
How about that? You're a grandfather, eh?
I'm a grandfather, yeah. Nine grandchildren, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, are you living here now?
No, we're out here for a visit.
Oh, yeah.
I still live in Gary, Indiana.
Still live in Gary, Indiana.
Yes.
Gary, Indiana.
Go ahead.
You know that? It's as far as I go, Mickey. Well, it's a pleasure to meet you and have you here with us, sir.
Yes.
Here's our first round question. Mickey, you may have A or B.
I shall have A.
You shall have A.
A.
Did you meet your? You married your high school sweetheart.
Yeah, I married the prettiest girl in high school.
Well, now I have to dispute that because I married a girl from Gary, Indiana.
But
Horace Mann High School.
Well, that was after my time. Mine was Emerson High School.
Oh, I see. Well, that's because I'm a lot older than you, Mickey.
Before Horace Mann was built yet.
Here we go. Paula said to her boyfriend, "I have good news and bad news." The good news is everything I have is yours. The bad news is I have blank. I like this one.
It's cute, isn't it? What famous football player comes from Gary, Indiana?
Tom Harmon.
Wrong.
Oh, yeah, Alex Karras, of course. Are you having a little difficulty, my friend?
Yes, I am.
Why, this is a wonderful, easy question. All right. Here we go. Mickey Eisley. Paula said to her boyfriend, "I have good news and bad news. The good news is everything I have is yours. The bad news is I have blank."
Bad news is I have... can I say?
Can you say what?
Social disease.
A social disease? Yeah, I guess you can say that. Okay.
With Jesus. Can I help it if I'm bashful?
Mickey, you can say that, but I tell you, whisper it that way, and we won't tell the others what you've said.
We'll just whisper.
That's right. We'll just keep it
with
between
Jean's
the two
permission.
Of us. All right.
Social
what
disease?
Do you say?
Is that official? His official answer?
That's his official answer.
Well, then mine is similar because nothing of value.
Nothing of value. That's a good one there. I got plenty of nothing.
And nothing's plenty for me.
Yes, Charles.
Get your glasses on, Brent.
I said nothing but the love in my heart and a bad back.
Nothing but the love in my heart and a bad back. Guy says, got good news, bad news. Good news is everything I have is yours. The bad news is I have...
Mumps.
Mumps. Well, I suppose it's contagious, but it's really not a social disease, is it? What do you say?
Bad news is I have the heartbreak of psoriasis.
Yes. I'm... What?
Can I say that on television?
Can you say what?
That on television.
Can you say that on television? Yes. A disease. Card says a disease, but what she meant was, they were really, you see, she was afraid to say it. Well, Mickey, nice try, old bean.
Don't cry, fam.
They're all watching back in Gary, Indiana.
That's right, so.
Now, Mickey, you stand by. We're going to do a little business with America. Goodbye, but hurry back. Tomorrow, there'll be more of the zaniness on Match Game 77 G-Revenue. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for Rothschild. From Shanana, John Bowser Bauman, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Ava Gabor, Artie Johnson, and from Flo, George Beaudoin, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Okay. Hey, Karen. What's that out there? Thank you for joining us here. Come over here with me and see who we have.
Who do we have?
We have a good bunch over here.
What have we here?
We have a dandy group here.
We're called the Camarillo Six.
Thank you.
Hello.
I dressed up just for yous.
You wore your...
Watch it.
Bangles, bojangles, and beads and all that.
Isn't it nice?
Yeah, that's the real thing, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Has that got a history?
Yeah, I'll try my hands and go mouth. I said, oh, yeah,
You boys have you all right.
Yeah. So are the rings. The rings are the real things, too.
No,
that's
they're
all fake.
Imitation.
Right.
No?
All
yeah.
Artificial. Let's say hello to Linda Love and Peter Glickman. Now let's get acquainted with the two of you. Peter, we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
Okay. I'm retired, and I play the stock market and the commodity market. And in my spare time, I rent my head out as a model for a geodesic dome.
And he's in show business. You're retired. You look a little young to be retired.
It's my second time to be retired.
It is.
Yeah.
And
I went to law school the first time.
Have you got one of those big computers and you do the market with that?
No.
No, you just do it in your head. And that's why you lost your hair, right? Sure. All right, good luck, Peter. Linda.
Hi, Pete. I'm a medical secretary for a cardiologist. I moved here 3 years ago from Minnesota, but I'm originally from Decatur, Illinois. Oh. I have a wonderful son called Scoopy.
Wonderful. Scoopy, that's
right.
A good name.
Decatur,
all right, Decatur, Illinois, that's a great place. Here on Match Game PM, you'll each have three opportunities to match as many of the dingbats as you possibly can. The one who's done that most often will be the winner. At the end of the third round, and that person will go on to play the big money super match, which can pay off over $20,000.
All right! Yeah, yeah.
Peter, A or B?
Let's start out with A.
A. All right, A. Paul said,
yeah.
My wife is the world's worst cook. I just used a pot of her coffee as blank. World's worst cook. Just look at that. You see, now, if he had a full head of hair, you can't see anything.
It must be terrible to lose your hair. How does a man...
Not when you're making money at it.
How does a man...
How did you make money?
How do you adjust to that?
The market.
I can tell you how I adjusted to it in about 2 minutes. No, he looks like I do in the morning before I find my glasses, and then I have to remember where I put the hair. And sometimes if I'm listening to records, it sticks between the albums, and it takes me a hell of a while. But I'm pretty anyway, so what the hell?
That's right. Here we go, Peter. Paul said, my wife is the world's worst cook. I just used a pot of her coffee as...
Shoe polish.
Shoe polish. That's what he said.
It is tragic to lose your hair. Imagine nothing to grease back.
That's right.
Oh, I said, hope I spelled this right. Foitalizer.
Foitalizer. Not bad for a college grad.
F-O-I-T-I-L-I-C-U-H.
That's very good. Okay, Brett.
Well, we all have our specialties. I know nothing about the stock market, but I said paint remover. Mm-hmm.
Paint remover, I think, is quite good. Too good a response so far.
I said gas for the car.
Gas for the car.
Gas
My
for
wife,
the
world's worst cook, just used a pot of her coffee as what, Ava?
Well, you see, I can't cook either, and doesn't coffee get very hard when it's very bad?
It's hard.
Hard coffee is the worst kind of drink. I know a guy that choked to death on hard coffee.
Hungarian coffee is very hard.
I need an ice throat, a big hard chunk of coffee.
If it doesn't get hard, it makes everything hard. So I said starch.
Starch?
I mean, my pancakes used to be so hard in Green Acres.
Oh, really? That's right.
That's good. Has its own internal logic.
I got very logical.
Paint remover.
Paint remover, I think, is a good one. He's looking for shoe polish. Not likely to get it here, is he, Joyce?
Not with this group.
About that morning coffee you invited me to.
Forget it.
I said a suntan lotion.
Suntan lotion. That's not bad.
Now,
we have one of equal difficulty for you. Bernie is the world's greatest salesman.
Mm-hmm.
A really great salesman. Why, he even sold birth control pills to blank. Bernie is the world's greatest salesman. He even sold birth control pills to blank.
A nun?
A nun, good. A nun. That's a wonderful answer.
I know why. Make sure she didn't get none.
Okay,
John.
Yeah, I may have a gender problem here, but, you know, we didn't have these things in the 50s. I said the Pope.
The Pope. The Pope was good. Yeah.
That girl call herself a Christian? Is that what you
it's
call herself,
match.
A Christian?
It was a good answer. It's a very good answer.
Well, I find it depressing, but I suppose what can I do? Oh, Sisters of the Sacred Heart?
Aha!
My nun that I always have to plug every time we come to a nun answer, which is, you know, thank goodness she wasn't in the bra business, because she'd get more plugs on this show. But my friend Sister Marie La Select from Hartford, who I love and who helped me. And in her memory, I give Mother Teresa.
Mother Teresa. There's another nun. All right. Now, Ava, what have you got for us here?
I am shocked. That's what I got. It's a sacrilegious group. I said men. They
Amen.
Don't have to take it, do they?
Well, yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Well, they do.
No, she's not supposed. They don't have nuns in Budapest. No. They all have some. They have some. They didn't want to wear the clothes. Nuns can't wear that.
They're so bad. So bad.
All right. He even sold birth control pills too.
A monastery.
A monastery. That's an impossible place. Right.
Oh, is that nice?
Yes.
Is that not nice?
I like it.
No, I think it's good.
Too.
What do you
a
say?
A monastery cannot be either male or female,
it's
you know.
A female monastery.
No, a monastery is...
Femastery.
No, it could be a nunnery.
Yeah, a nunnery.
Nonastery.
Get thee to a monastery.
A fremastery? No.
I thought it couldn't possibly be a nun because they couldn't get in the habit. And so... I said to Renee Richards.
Renee Richards. All right. That's round one. She's ahead, 2-0, but we have two more rounds to go, and we'll go right after this. There we go. Now we go to round two. All right. Linda, you're ahead. You have to go first.
Okay, Gene, I'll go with A.
You want A?
Okay.
You got it. You want it. Rocket Robert is the world's fastest runner.
Yeah.
Rocket Robert. Oh.
Thank you. He's so fast that when he ran in the 100-yard dash, he crossed the finish line and his blank was still at the starting line.
trying to do.
Burt Reynolds gave it to him, I guess.
He wants to cover up his nakedness, Mr. Goodman
no.
does. Yeah.
Hey.
Okay, Peter.
Disentire him.
All right,
Linda, here we go. Rocket Robert is the world's fastest runner. He's so fast that when he ran in the 100-yard dash, he crossed the finish line and his blank was still at the starting line.
His tennis shoes.
You're not going to wear it, Peter? You're not.
It was nice, but it's a little big, actually. Hey, we may have a new series here.
From the Rio Grande,
and your cheeks ain't tan. You're an old cowhand, never saw a cow, never milked up.
They said this was an intellectual show. What am I doing here?
What?
Either you got it or you don't, Gene. I will now give an example of how a cowboy like me takes off his hat to a lady.
How?
And in a breeze that's worse.
Okay, John, go.
I will now give an example of how a cowboy like me matches a lady.
Track shoes. All right, there's one. Get up next.
I said foot.
Foot.
Which is in the tennis shoe.
Foot.
And you, sir, what did you say?
I'm a devotee of the track, and I said his athletic supporter.
Ah. Well, what did you say?
I don't know if I spelled it right, but it's the same thing. Nikes.
Oh, yeah, those are shoes. Right.
Nikes.
All right, Peter, here we go. Nick said.
Yeah.
Nick said, this has got to be the world's oldest restroom. On the wall, it says, for a good time, call blank.
Linda, do you sing?
Yes, I do.
You have a face that looks different.
Thank you.
Nick said, this has got to be the world's oldest restroom. On the wall, it says, for a good time, call blank.
Call Eve.
Eve. All right, that's going back. Eve was good. What do you have, John?
I was thinking, I have Cleopatra.
Cleopatra's very good with a phone
213.
Number.
I have the phone number.
Yeah, right.
Is that Egypt, 213?
Yeah, that's Egypt.
Crazy. Well, I said, Mary Magdalene, but she said no, she didn't want that. So I said Noah's wife?
But she wasn't
Nobody
known.
Nobody knows she played
See,
around.
Cleopatra's good because she was known for fooling around.
Yeah, Noah's
well,
wife
so
was
is Noah's wife. That's
no,
how much you know about.
Was,
no, she wasn't even in show
Noah's
business.
Noah's wife never
she
fooled around.
She had emotional problems. She wasn't that busy.
Show us your card.
Now, so that it's a match. I'm not saying it's not a match. The number to call is Apple 92241. And she didn't use her name, Eve. She changed it to a stage name, Evie Ann.
Evie Ann.
But it's Eve. Right.
In the garden.
That was a long, boring answer.
All right, Eva, let's see yours.
Marie Dressler.
Well, you really gave it to her, Brett, didn't you?
Brett Summers gave
her
that
one. How kind of you, Brett?
She's getting back at you, Eva.
I guess.
Okay, Artie, go.
I had another Marie before she lost her head.
Marie Antoinette.
Yes.
All right.
I got confused. I didn't see
You always have to.
So what else is new?
Oh, my goodness. I didn't hear the... I heard
yes,
restroom.
Yes, you did.
I didn't hear which restroom, so I wrote St. Peter.
Oh, boy.
You and I are
All right, round three. Final round. 4-1 the score. Linda, A or B?
I'll take A again, Gene.
A it is. Two people play.
You and me, Uber.
Yes, here we go. This is it. Alfredo the chef said, my new chain of restaurants is so bad, whenever I rent a new location, a blank opens up next door.
closes the restaurant business,
you don't play.
I'm going to help my friend.
Oh.
If anyone's in New York, you could go to Alfredo Biazzi's, which is in the Village. Alfredo's is a terrific trattoria.
I want you to know he gets more free meals than
I never have been there. He's just a friend.
All right, here we go, Linda.
Gosh.
Alfredo, the chef, said, my new chain of restaurants is so bad, whenever I rent a new location, a blank opens up next door.
McDonald's?
Oh! You didn't listen. You didn't listen carefully.
What did you say?
She said McDonald's because she didn't hear.
McDonald's?
She didn't hear the...
She's as bad as me. I said, oh, don't you want to know what I said?
Yes, I do want to know.
I said a hospital.
A hospital. That's it.
And I said a corpasta pace.
Ah, of course, pasta patches is your body better than a hospital.
Also a cemetery.
Right. Now, here's the way it is, Peter. You need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Weird Wanda is really weird.
How weird is Weird Wanda?
She doesn't have a belly button. She has a belly blank.
Oh, I don't play. It's so much fun. I have found this game to be so much fun, and I'm upset I'm not playing.
Why not?
Peter.
Weird Wanda is really weird. She doesn't have a belly button. She has a belly blank.
A belly zipper.
Yeah! Belly zipper is good. You didn't think of it, John? What's got...
I thought of something that I thought was quite akin to the truth, but it's not zipper, it's snap.
John, what has happened to your mind?
I think this makes perfect sense.
You used to have a mind, John, but it is lost. It has abandoned you completely.
What? Covered with grease, that's all.
Grease for peace, I think is a good answer.
Really? Yeah. All right.
Down in his head.
It's more like a button than a zipper.
That's true.
Greasy brains he's got.
He's going to talk all the way through my answer, and is she going to answer
You're on, dear.
Go.
Thank you. I did a little play on words.
Yeah.
Belly full.
A belly full.
Thank you, my darling. You're all sweet.
All right. Now you got to match a bottom tier, Peter, and stay in the game. What have you got, Ava?
I wanted a zipper, and I said a snap.
A snap. So that means Linda
wins
the game.
I said a zipper.
Zipper.
I said a zipper.
And you look 20 years younger. You've got to get one. Ava, send him one, would you please? Dirty one. Where is it then? The hair people are gone. All right. Turn the thing around, Charles, and go off with him, and we'll see what happens. So long, Charles. Got a little message for you, America. Watch this. Now, here we go. Linda Love could win a bundle of money here. Good luck to you. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank of you. 500 for matching the most popular, 250 for the second, and 100 for the third. Whom do you want to call on for a little help?
Charles.
You just want my hair, don't you, sugar? I have such pretty hair. Full of you.
All right, full of you.
Bowser.
What do you got, Bowser?
Because of you.
Because of
it's a
you.
Song.
Yes, indeed.
Artie.
All of you.
All of you. Those are the three they gave you. Now you choose one of those or think up one of your own.
All of me. All of me.
I said all of you. It's none of your business.
You want to make a bet? I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Because of you.
Because of you.
Because
all right, that's John
Danforth.
Let's find out if it's up there under the $100 response.
Gene,
all of you.
If mine is on there.
All of you, it made it.
If mine is on there, I'll throw my hat in the air.
All right. Along with his wig.
Let's take a look at the next one. Because of you is there. What do you think is on top?
I dream of you. I dream of you.
Audience, what's on top?
Thinking of you.
Thinking of you
is
the other one.
Slide it. Thinking of you. Very good.
That's great.
$250 means at least you'll play for us $2,500, but you got one more shot at it. Here it is. Blank parents. All right.
Oh, Brett.
Oh, golly. Grandparents.
Yeah. Eva. Proud parents.
Yes. Proud parents.
Artie's?
Foster parents.
Oh. All right. Foster parents, grandparents, proud parents. You want one of those?
We're going to go with grandparents.
All right. Go, go, go. Let's see if grandparents is under the $100 response. Step-parents is there. No, it's not there. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Godparents is there.
Oh,
she wants it's grandparents. It's go. She's got it. All right. All right. Now, you've got another $500. You have a total of $7,500 you are playing for. But you can double that and play for $15,000 if you get a lucky spin of the star wheel. So step up there, give it a whirl, and we'll all root for a double, won't we? Here we go. $15,000. Good luck to you. Here it is. Flux. Blank sky. S K Y. Blank sky.
Okay.
All right. Brett's ready. You give us the answer that she has on the card. We give you $15,000. What do you say?
Blue sky.
Blue sky. All right,
you're stupid. That's why you're just stupid.
You know, I've been so depressed this week. I feel so terrible. But in spite of that, I said, no.
Linda says she's going to put this money to good use. She's going to use it as a down payment on a house that she and her son have been looking for. $15,750. Thank you. One and all, you were splendid. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
T-shirts, jerseys, baseball and fashion shirts, T-shirts plus. Rulacort cream and lotion with hydrocortisone from Lederle Laboratories for rich in inflammation and poison ivy, insect bites and other minor skin irritations. And Turtle Wax, the world's largest selling liquid car wax, cleans, polishes, protects. And Turtle Wax Super Hard Shell Car Wax Kit cleans, waxes, seals in the shine.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.